There was one devotee by name Chokamela. He is from Pandharpur area. A staunch devotee of the Lord, a great singer. And he used to sing and dance in front of the Lord. So when he used to sing and dance, people will become mesmerized by his activities. But since he is coming from a low background, after all his singing and dancing is over, again everybody will reject him. Not to be touched, Harijana, Shudra, like that category. They all go away. But his service is because he was not allowed to enter into the temple. There were some rules at that time. Not everybody was given access to the temple. So for the pleasure of the Lord, he used to sing and dance whole day there. And he used to go back home, not to entertain crowd or anything. His desire was to satisfy the Lord with his singing and dancing. But the problem is, material world will not be able to consider his devotion. They only see his external bodily designations. And some people started questioning his capacity of bhakti. If you are so truthful, so bhakti, so devoted to the Lord, why did Lord not change the rules to give you an opportunity to enter into the temple? Why he is not facilitating you? So yours is not true bhakti, you are a imitation fellow. You are simply trying to draw public's attention for cheap name, fame and all these things. They were criticizing him, they challenged even him. If you are so great devotee, let Lord give you opportunity to have darshan. So when he was challenged so severely, he felt very bad. He went home and wife asked him, why are you so bad? Why are you so sorry? Then he explained the situation. He is saying, why did Lord give us an opportunity? Why is that? You know, he started giving various arguments and all, but people were not ready to hear the arguments. His wife, he was trying to explain the mood, what he was going through. It is the Lord who has created us. So why is this discrimination in the society? Like that and all, he was feeling bad that, yes, if Lord is so great, he could have given me an opportunity. So without even eating food, he went to bed. Wife was also very concerned that he may not commit some wrong step. Whole night she was waiting there without blinking the eyes, so that she is trying to attentively protect him. So when he was somewhere in the dead of the night, Lord Panduranga Vittala could not tolerate his devotees' sorrow. He came out of the altar, came to their house. And as soon as the Lord came there, in the darkness became the entire brightness. Because Lord is that self-effulgent personality. All the darkness around the thing vanished. And Lord came and called him Chokamela. Immediately Chokamela got up, both wife and husband came and served the Lord, paid obeisances, and whatever they had, they brought some naivedya and offered to the Lord, and they fed the Lord with whatever minimum they could do, and Lord was very much satisfied. Then Lord said, please come with me, I'll take you to the temple to have darshan. He said, no sir, this is not correct. The society will not appreciate. I am here not to satisfy the society, I am here to satisfy you, Lord Yusana. Then Lord personally took his hand and they started walking towards the temple, and the doors were closed. They entered through the closed doors only. When they came near the altar, Lord was asking, please come inside the altar, Garbhagruha. No, again the devotee said, one step back, he said, and sir, no, I cannot break the principle of the society. I am an untouchable person. Even you have called me till here is the greatest thing, and then you are taking me inside. Then tomorrow all these people will handle me. I will not be able to handle them. He said, because of these foolish talks, my altar is filled with ignorance and darkness. And today when you come, then actually my altar will be brightly glowing. So like that there was argumentation between the Lord and the devotee, and Lord finally took him near the altar. And in the meantime, it was Mangalarti time. The pujari came to open the door and he was able to hear some conversation happening between two people. So as soon as he opened the door, he saw Chokamela near the altar. And he became so angry. How come you came into the altar? How is that? You have come here after all our warnings and all. We said you cannot enter the temple, so you have stealthily came here either to steal the jewelry of the Lord or something to do. Any negative intention. He was taken in front of the judiciary system next day morning. Then he was explaining that it was Lord personally who had brought them there. They were not ready to listen. How can Lord personally come for you? We have been worshipping the Lord for so long time and Lord has not given us an opportunity, and you are saying that Lord has come personally and he took you inside. So then he was punished for his arrogance act. Today he has come, tomorrow he may go directly into the altar. So we should see that he doesn't stay near the temple. So they banished him to stay opposite right of the river, Krishna Bhaga river, Chandra Bhaga river there was. So he should stay opposite side of the river. So people were thinking, staying opposite side of the river, Lord is not there. The Lord is there only this side of the river. Lord is there everywhere. What is the limitation for him? So one day, because he was banned from the temple, he was sitting in the house only, and outside the courtyard is a huge tree. So under the tree he was sitting there, and he was in meditation of the Lord, and wife was serving him prasadam. So in the temple also there was lunch time, and Lord was offered lunch, and altar was closed, and pujari went away. So the Lord, feeling the separation from his devotee, came to his house. And at that time they were about to have the lunch, then as soon as they saw the Lord, they became very happy. They gave him one asana to sit down. Both wife and husband were serving the Lord. So he was personally relishing their food cooked by them. So in anxiety and enthusiasm, wife spilled some of the curds onto the dhoti of the Lord. Because when we are excited, we don't know how our body will be responding. We'll be shaking and all, something like that and all is happening. And out of anxiety, enthusiasm, she spilled some of the curds onto the dhoti. And he became very angry and he scolded the wife. See, you have spoiled the dhoti of the Lord. Be conscious in your service. Be attentive. In the meantime, the head pujari was passing by the same nearby place. When he saw this person, he only could see both wife and husband, Chokamela and his wife. He could not see the Lord sitting there. He thought they were criticizing him. He became very angry, came near Chokamela and slapped him heavily. And he went to river, took bath and went to the temple to do the formalities, because he touched an untouchable person. In the meantime, Lord vanished from there. The evening 4 o'clock, 4:30, when he opened the temple, when he saw the deity of the Lord's cheek was swollen and tears were coming out of his eyes. Lord was crying there. Immediately it was a shock for his life. It's like a thunderbolt. What is this? Lord cheek is swallowed and his tears were coming. Then he thought, what had happened in the day? Why is Lord acting in this way? Then he remembered he had messed up with Chokamela. Because he has slapped Chokamela, Lord is reciprocating the situation. He immediately went to the senior people there, consulted him what to do. Then under their guidance, he immediately ran to Chokamela's place. So Chokamela was surprised that the head pujari is coming to him, running and running, came up to him, fell at his feet and begged forgiveness. Please come. And he explained the whole scenario, how the Lord is continuously crying and his cheek is swollen. So immediately feeling that Lord is taking all this situation for him, Chokamela went to the altar and as explained, how this face and all the details were exactly, Lord was like that. And then he started offering prayers. He requested the Lord, please forgive us. We are like children. Children do mistakes. Parents, forgive them. And you are the most compassionate personality. Please treat our insignificant activities and with compassion and please forgive us. So like that and all he did, and the Lord became satisfied and his ever smiling face came back to normal. So after some time, one day there was one great devotee by name Namadev who visited the temple. So when he was singing and chanting, suddenly he saw Lord crying there. So when he was crying there, he asked the Lord, why are you crying, my dear Lord? What is that made you so sorrow? Then Lord said, there was one my great devotee by name Chokamela. He passed away. That's why I am crying. So he said, why are you crying? He has passed away means he has come there to associate with you in the spiritual world. What is there? Separation for you from him. No, he had one desire and that desire could not be fulfilled. Can you fulfill that desire for me? Yes, sir. I am there for your purpose. Please order me. What should I do? So because of some accident, that entire wall collapsed on the people who are all working there. And almost some 10-15 people got buried there under the wall. And Chokamela was part of that burial. And since they could not differentiate who was who, they gave a mass burial to all these 10-15 people. And Chokamela had one desire, that his body be cremated within my campus. Now he said, sir, 10-15 people you are saying, all are buried. Now how do I know who is Chokamela? Because it's a mass burial. So then Krishna says, you do one thing, you take up each bone and if you keep it near your ear, it will be, if it is Chokamela's body, because whole life he is chanting my holy name, that bone will reciprocate Hari Hari Vittala, Hari Hari Vittala. So when he said like that, he went, Namdev, they opened the burial and there were many bones there. He started picking some, every bone, and some bones When he kept near the ear, the holy name of Vitala was resounding from his bones. Then he collected all that bones, brought it there, and in front of the temple, a samadhi is made for Chokamela, and even today, devotees come there, have darshan of Chokamela in the Lord. So that is the capacity of the Lord. They never questioned the Lord. Edrushta labha santushtaha. They lived by the principles of Bhagavad Gita, what Lord had taught. So that commitment we have to show. Then Lord will act from His side. He will give the best opportunity how to glorify the devotee. Devotee is whole life trying to glorify the Lord, and Lord is trying to glorify His devotee. So such an opportunity we have been blessed by having Prabhupada with us, who has satisfied the desires of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to take the holy name across the world and give opportunity for all of us, unfortunate souls, all of us, to engage in their service. That's their compassion and mercy upon us. So let us utilize this opportunity and make our life successful. I'll stop.